In this lesson, we look at how to assess information assets to enable cost-effective security and risk assessments. I use sample data sets for classification and categorization. In order to understand our risks and how to focus our security efforts, we need to identify and assess all information assets. The two ways we assess our assets are via classification and categorization. Classification assesses the sensitivity of data. It also enables an organization to apply the proper controls and procedures to prevent unauthorized access, improper retention, and unsafe destruction. The classification labels applied differ across industries and organizations. A common classification method for commercial organizations includes the levels confidential, sensitive, private, proprietary, and public. In this classification scheme, confidential is the most sensitive classification. Data classified at this level are usually subject to statutes, regulation, or contractual obligations. A breach of this data may result in high business impact. EPHI, PII, and payment card data fall under this classification. Data classified as sensitive have a lower risk profile, but losing the data will result in significant business impact. The impact is often just loss of reputation. However, it can also result in loss of competitiveness. Strategy documents and inter-organizational correspondence fall under this classification. Data that falls under the private classification might not do a lot of damage to a business, but management wants it kept private. Examples include detailed information about a new product, employee retention numbers, and salary ranges. Proprietary classification is for data that may be disclosed outside the organization with limitations. Organizations should create procedures to authorize release of proprietary information. If public data is lost, there is little to no business impact. Before moving to categorization, it is important to understand how we use classification. Classification is related to confidentiality. Unlike categorization, it only addresses the confidentiality factor of the CIA trilogy. Part of the classification step is inventorying information assets. Once classification is complete, we can begin categorization. The two primary objectives of categorizations are assigning a value to each asset and determining the overall risk tolerance management has for each data set and associated systems. According to the Federal Information Processing Standard, FIPS 199, there are three qualitative categories: low, medium, and high. The FIPS 199 categorization is included in the CISSP Common Body of Knowledge. We apply categories to each element of the CIA: confidentiality, integrity, and availability. This is a table from FIPS 199. It shows the guidelines for the high, medium, and low categories for confidentiality. Note that the greater the level of business impact from the loss of confidentiality, the higher the category. This is the same across integrity and availability. This is an example of how we might categorize PII. Confidentiality of PII is categorized as high because it is covered by the EU's GDPR and state privacy regulations. Medium is assigned to integrity. Lack of accuracy of the PII collected by this organization would not cause catastrophic business impact. Availability is categorized as medium because loss of access would only temporarily cause business process interruption because of existing business continuity plans. Not all organizations would categorize PII this way. Categorization depends on the value of the data set to the organization and the impact if the data is breached, changed without authorization, or unavailable. In this lesson, I focused on data. However, we also categorize systems. How we categorize a system depends on its value to supporting critical business processes. It also depends on the classification and categorization of the data it processes or stores. We use data in system categorizations when performing risk assessments. They enable the assessor to accurately determine risk. That's it for this lesson. If you have questions, please ask. And until next time, be careful what you click.